Hello, my name is Oliver Schmidt. Today I'm gonna show you how you can make use of your Apple II Ethernet card to set the date for Protos 8 file operations if you don't have a real-time clock in your Apple IIe. First, let's have a look how things normally look like without any clock. I'm now booting into Protos 8. Okay, here we are. Now I'm saving some dummy file. And when I bring up the catalog, you see that the dummy file I just created says no date. Pretty ugly, isn't it? So when you have an Ethernet card installed in your Apple IIe, but no real-time clock, you can make use of my program date 65. It comes in two versions. One version, called date 65 system, is especially designed to be integrated into the Protos 8 boot process. On boot, Protos 8 runs always the first file named .system. Usually that's basic system. However, if you put date 65 system as first .system file on your boot disk, date 65 system will get run. So far, so good. But it would be awkward to have to manually run the usual .system file afterwards. Therefore, date 65 system looks for the net.system file on your boot disk and will run it. This way, you can chain date 65 system into your Protos 8 boot process. Let's see how this works. I'm now again booting into Protos 8. But this time with date 65 present. Here we are. It gets an IP address, gets the time, sets the date, and now changes to basic system. Now I'm again saving a dummy file. And when I bring up the catalog again, you see that the dummy file now shows with today's date. Nice, isn't it? In case you're wondering what the date 65 TC file is all about, it's a simple 3-character text file allowing you to configure your time zone. That's all. Thanks for watching. Bye!